Hello everyone, my name is Jared Hybart. I am a product manager with Yokogawa, and today we'll be covering how to calibrate your FC800D and FLXA402. First, we're going to cover the zero calibration. As with most other analyzers, the zero calibration gets rid of background noise from the measurement circuit and gives you a good base for your measurement. To start your calibration, the first thing you want to do is switch your analyzer into maintenance mode. On the home screen, you can press the maintenance button. This will pop up a dialog. Do you want to turn on maintenance mode? Select yes, and is now in maintenance mode. So this way, the operator knows that the analyzer is not measuring correctly and does not have any issues. We're going to turn off the measurement electrode rotation. Next thing we want to do is remove the electrode from the flow cell. You can do this by, there's two screws on the underside of the flow cell. Undo these. These are captain screws, so they'll stay with the flow cell. You can lift the electrode assembly off and put it into maintenance position, which is where these two slots to the right of the flow cell are and align with the two pins on the measurement assembly. Once you have put the measurement assembly into maintenance position, you can go ahead and dry off the measurement electrode so that there's no excess process on it and make sure that the motor is turning and the measurement electrode is spinning. Once it is spinning, you can go ahead and click the calibration button on the home screen, which will take you to the calibration menu. From here, you will select your zero calibration. This will make a screen appear that shows your current measurement as well as a back button and a check stability button. Once your reading on your measurement section has stabilized, go ahead and click the check stability button. This will allow the analyzer to measure stability and make sure that the reading is actually stable. Once it is stable, a button that says next will appear. This will set the calibration. So you can see what your stable reading was, what your cal point is, which for the zero calibration should be zero. By clicking the next button, it will take you to another screen that will show you what your zero point is and what your current measurement is. On this screen, you'll see a back, accept, and abort. Back will take you to the previous step. Accept will accept the calibration and save it. If you don't hit accept, it will not save the calibration. Hitting abort will go back to the calibration menu without saving anything. Once you hit accept, your zero calibration is done, and we can move on to a span calibration. Now is a good time to move the measurement assembly from the maintenance position to the measurement position. This will allow you to get your process measurement you need for your span calibration. Now that we've done a zero calibration, we'll move on to the span calibration. The FC800D uses a process calibration for its span calibration. So this uses what your process value is to calibrate your span. Because of this, the FC800D has a sample valve in the middle front of the flow cell. This will allow you to take a fresh sample of your process and take that to your lab for analysis or use your handheld chlorine analyzer to take a measurement of that sample. Once you have that value, we can go ahead and enter into calibration mode. So just like your zero calibration, you want to make sure that you're in maintenance mode and click the calibration button on the home screen. From here, you will select slope calibration. Once you do this, you'll see a familiar screen that will show your current measured value as well as a back and check stability. As long as your reading is fairly stable, go ahead and click check stability. This will allow the analyzer to make sure that you don't have any drastic changes in what you're measuring. If this isn't the case, you'll see a next button appear and it will show your current reading and a cal point reading. In this cal point here, you want to actually click on that and input what your handheld or your lab measurement was. So this is your input in your actual value that it should be reading at. Once you've done this, you go ahead and click next and it'll calculate the slope and go to the next screen where it'll show you your new current measurement value as well as your new slope. If this value looks right, then go ahead and hit accept. If not, you can try the calibration again or cancel the calibration. Once you hit accept, this actually saves the calibration data into the analyzer and you're good to start your measurement again. Now that we've finished our calibration, we can make sure that the FC800's measurement assembly is tightened down onto the flow cell and that all process valves are open. If this is the case, you can go ahead and turn maintenance mode off and start measuring the process again. Thank you, everyone. I hope you now understand how to calibrate your FC800D. If you have any other questions or would like more information, please visit yokogawa.com.